It is 1927. It has been 7 years since the German National Railway was formed. But still, stations and goods yards had to rely on old state railway designs for shunting, many of them dating back to the 19th century. But that was about to change by a very confident new locomotive. So confident, indeed, that serial production started without having built and tested a single prototype. When in 1920, the former German state railways merged to form the Deutsche Reichsbahn, the German National Railway, the heterogeneity of the inherited locomotive types was especially obvious among shunting locomotives. A plethora of different classes, many of them already very old, were maintained and employed, presenting somewhat of an economic nightmare, with every class requiring their own spare parts, specially trained staff, and often having very limited capabilities. To combat all these issues, multiple different sized modern shunting locomotives were developed and standardized. The first and smallest one of them, a three-axle machine, was the Class 80, or in German, Baureihe 80. The design is based around two main concerns: using as many standardized parts as possible, and creating a machine as powerful as reasonable, within its small size. Additionally, in respect of route availability, a light machine was preferred, and the specifications were set at 17.5 tons per axle. Combining all these expectations, however, proved to be an impossible task. For the sake of standardization, it was equipped with many fittings originally used for the Class R1, a large express locomotive. Developed for mainline engines, these parts were of solid construction, and as such a lot heavier than what would have been necessary for a shunter. Combined with large cylinders, and a powerful and as such fairly heavy boiler, radical weight savings were needed in other areas of the locomotive, leading to the unusually small driving wheels with a diameter of only 110 cm, about 3 feet and 7 inches. These weight issues, however, were still not fully resolved when approval was given, and skipping any prototypes, the first 27 machines were ordered from various locomotive builders, and in 1927, the first ones were delivered. The superheated locomotives produced 575 psi, which is almost twice as much as many of the machines they replaced, allowing them to pull almost 1400 tons at steady 35 km per hour. With the less challenging loads, they could even reach a top speed of 45 km per hour, making them perfect for demanding shunting duties of all sorts. As such, they became popular, especially at busy stations, where they could clear tracks much quicker than the three-axle predecessors could, and outperformed even almost all of the four-axle shunters. But maybe this was also a sign that something wasn't quite right. The requested design specifications were very optimistic right from the beginning. The locomotive industry struggled to develop a machine so powerful without exceeding the predetermined axle load of just 17.5 tons. And what at last the numbers matched up on paper? It's only there where they did. The built machines had a factual axle load of up to over 19 tons. Add this to the top-heavy boiler, the short wheelbase with long overhangs, and the lack of any guiding axles, and you have a locomotive moving and bouncing like a corkscrew, increasing wear and causing a worrying number of derailments. By 1929, 39 machines had been built. Further orders were stalled, however, due to the Great Depression. After all, there was still a large and healthy fleet of old shunters available, making new builds an easy cut on expenses. And when by the mid-1930s construction of new shunters was resumed, enough experience had been gathered to realize the Class 80 was the wrong path to begin with, and a simpler and lighter machine was needed. Even if that made it necessary to stray away from the use of standardized parts, leading finally to the development of the Class 89.0, which by the way didn't make it into large numbers either, due to the outbreak of the Second World War. Not that the Class 80 was an inherently bad design. After all, it was incredibly powerful and is such a favorite amongst crews. But it was too complex and too heavy for what it was intended to do. As such, the standard could never fulfill its role as being a standard. After the war, 22 machines remained in the eastern part of Germany, with the other 17 belonging to the western zones, splitting them up even more. As very small locomotive classes, and with the advent of far more economic diesel shunters, the railway operations in both parts of Germany withdrew them in the 1960s. Their strong pulling power, however, made them perfect for industrial use, and it is there where many of them saw a second life. Most notable is the West German mining operation Ruhrkohle AG, which kept them in service right until the end of steam in West Germany in 1977, and therefore played a fundamental role in preserving 5 of the 7 machines that still exist today. A staggering number, considering only 39 were ever built. Far from being the universal standard it was designed to be, it might be due to the large number of survivors, this class became a favorite amongst enthusiasts. The image of the class 80 as THE German shunting locomotive stuck, even though they actually could never live up to this expectation. I have been working with Blender for about 3.5 years by now, and do think it is about time to finally share my models with a wider audience, and the class 80 plays a special role here, as it was my first standard gauge locomotive. Its creation was certainly a steep learning curve, and when I finally presented it in late 2020 on my Instagram page, it still was far away from how it looks today, ever since I kept upgrading it to match my newer models. Often, however, the Class 80 was even the first model to receive new features. Over the past month, I once again regularly went back to clean it up, add some details, sharpen some others, and to be honest with you, I feel very comfortable where it is right now. While I will surely still find some details to tweak, the main goal going forward from here is to create a model of the Class 80 that can actually be 3D printed. But that is a whole other story for another day. Have you enjoyed my model showcase? Then fear not, this is just my first video of many more to come, so why not subscribe to catch them right as they release? If you don't want to wait for so long, however, then feel free to also check out my Instagram page, where you can find images and short animations of all the models I have created so far. And there's quite a good number of them. Which locomotive class would you like to see covered in a video next? Let me know in the comments. Have a great day, and see you next time at Steelbridge Models!